Abhimanyu. Abhimanyu is one of the short-lived and yet a prominent characters in the great epic of Mahabharata. Of all the great warriors of Mahabharata, Abhimanyu was the youngest and yet the greatest. It took seven of the great warriors on the side of the Kauravas to vanquish this young lion. Abhimanyu was the illustrious son of Arjuna. His mother Subhadra was the sister of Lord Krishna. Abhimanyu was married to Uttara and had a son Parikshit, who was born after Abhimanyu's death. Following the great war, Parikshit became the king and continued the family lineage of Bharat. His obedience to Yudhishthir by taking up the fatal assignment and his courage in confronting the enemy made him a hero greater than any of the Pandavas. He will ever be remembered for the valor he displayed in the Mahabharata war. In ancient India, there was a powerful kingdom whose capital was Hastinapur. This was located near today's Delhi. The kingdom belonged to two brothers, Dhritarashtra and Pandu. As the elder brother Dhritarashtra was blind, Pandu took care of the kingdom. He was ambitious and expanded the kingdom far and wide. Then he handed over the kingdom to his elder brother and retired to the forest to spend his final days. Pandu later had five sons, known as Pandavas. The eldest was Yudhishthir, and the others were Bhim, Arjun, Nakul, and Sahadev. Dhritarashtra, on the other hand, had 100 sons. They were known as Kauravas. After Pandu's sudden death, his five sons returned to Hastinapur and grew up with their cousin brothers, the sons of Dhritarashtra. When the time came, the kingdom was divided between the Kauravas and the Pandavas to rule. The Pandava brothers were highly proficient and honest. They managed their kingdom well and were liked by all. Their kingdom flourished. The Kauravas were jealous of the success of Pandavas, who proved to be superior in every count. Duryodhan, the eldest of the Kauravas, wanted to drive away the Pandavas so that he can rule the entire kingdom. He was waiting for an opportunity for the showdown of the Pandavas. Arjun, the third of the Pandavas, was a close friend of Krishna, who shines throughout the Mahabharata epic. Arjun had many sons with many wives, but he loved Abhimanyu the most. Abhimanyu's mother Subhadra was the sister of Arjun's close friend Krishna. Soon after Abhimanyu's birth, the relationship between the cousin brothers, Kauravas and Pandavas, became strained. Duryodhan by now planned the downfall of the Pandavas in order to swallow their kingdom. On advice from his maternal uncle Shakuni, he coaxed his father Dhritarashtra to invite the eldest of the Pandavas, Yudhishthir, for a friendly game of dice. Yudhishthir was too honest and sincere and easily fell prey to the plots laid down by the rogues, Duryodhan and his maternal uncle Shakuni. In the heat of the game, Yudhishthir lost his kingdom and had to go for 13 years of exile as the condition for the loser. In addition, during the 14th year, the Pandavas were supposed to go incognito, and if recognized, they have to start their exile all over. Yudhishthir understood the trick played on him by Shakuni, but his zeal for honesty prevented him to raise any voice. Abhimanyu was then only an infant when his father Arjun left for the jungle and his mother went to Dwarka with him to live with her brother Krishna. Abhimanyu was Krishna's favorite nephew. As he grew up, he became highly proficient in weaponry and learned about the injustice done to his father and to his uncles. He promised to win back the kingdom when he grows up. Everyone loved Abhimanyu as he reached his adulthood. Meanwhile, 13 years have passed, and in the 14th year, the Pandavas decided to live in the kingdom of Virat in disguise. At this time, the Kauravas attacked Virat with the suspicion that the Pandavas are perhaps hiding there. Virat's son Uttar was unable to resist the progress of the Kaurava army when they entered the palace through the back door. Arjun was at that time in the palace and was not in the war field. Arjun fought in disguise and defeated the Kauravas. Duryodhan could not recognize him. Arjun requested Uttar to take the credit of defeating the enemy without revealing his identity, at least for a while. Uttar agreed for its good reason. Virat came to know of the identity of the Pandavas in due course as they completed their 14th years of exile. Virat proposed to Arjun to get his daughter Uttara married to his son Abhimanyu. All parties agreed and Abhimanyu was married to Uttara. After the marriage, the Pandavas held a council in presence of Krishna where Yudhishthir proposed, "I would like to win back our kingdom without bloodshed." Krishna agreed to carry the message to the Kauravas. But Duryodhan was obstinate. "I refuse them even a pinch of land. Let them fight and take it if they can." Krishna failed to negotiate. Dhritarashtra, the blind father, could not oppose his eldest son, Duryodhan. War was declared. Even though Duryodhan was unjustified, some of the great warriors of that time fought for the Kauravas as they were faithful to the crown. Bhishma, the grandfather, was the greatest of the warriors. He was amazed to see Abhimanyu's fighting skill in the war field. But Pandavas were losing. Pandavas realized that they could never win as long as Bhishma is the commander of the Kaurava army. Krishna planned to remove Bhishma from the scene. Bhishma had a promise that he will not fight with Shikhandi, a eunuch, who was also a warrior. Krishna knew this secret. Krishna planned to use Shikhandi as a shield so that Arjun can bring down Bhishma. The plan worked and Bhishma fell. Drona immediately became the commander of the Kaurava army. Duryodhan asked Drona to capture Yudhishthir in order to end the war. Drona responded, "We can never take Yudhishthir as long as Arjun is by his side." Together with other warriors, he planned the circular troop formation called Vyuha, while assigning others to distract Arjun and take him away from Yudhishthir. The plan worked, and Yudhishthir was about to be captured when Yudhishthir called upon Abhimanyu to lead in absence of Arjun. Abhimanyu knew how to break Drona's army formation, which was progressing towards the capture of their commander Yudhishthir. But he did not know how to come out of it in case he was overpowered. He shared his thoughts with Yudhishthir. Yudhishthir assured Abhimanyu to follow him closely while he breaks the circular array. Abhimanyu charged with his eyes fixed on Duryodhan. No one could stop him. Drona was alarmed and he could see the superior ability of Abhimanyu. Abhimanyu broke through Drona's impenetrable circular array and approached Duryodhan very fast. Kaurava army was on the run. Right at this time, the army commander Jayadratha successfully closed in the broken army formation and prevented the Pandavas to penetrate. Abhimanyu was trapped inside, but continued to kill the Kaurava armies all around him while fast approaching Duryodhan. Drona was alarmed. He ignored the code of war of fighting one with one and called upon all the warriors to join and kill Abhimanyu. Karna cut the reins of the horses and Abhimanyu became immobile. Then he cut his bow from behind. Abhimanyu jumped to the ground with his sword facing all the seven great warriors at the same time. It was difficult to get close when Drona cut his swords and Karna cut his shield. Abhimanyu was disabled, but undaunted, he picked up the wheel of his chariot and began whirling it against his unfair and unjust enemies, but he was completely encircled. Arrows came whizzing from all directions, and soon the wheels lay broken in pieces. Abhimanyu then picked up a mace that was lying on the field. Dushasan's son closed in and fight started until both were exhausted and lay on the ground. But Dushasan's son was the first to get up. He wasted no time to bring the mace down on Abhimanyu's head while he was trying to get up. Abhimanyu fell dead. The Kaurava warriors, like savages, rejoiced around the fallen young warrior. Not one of them, however, outlived the war. The Pandava brothers avenged Abhimanyu by killing all the warriors one by one in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. Mahabharata is not just a story of war that happened many years ago. It is a story that will hold its eternal value forever. Symbolically, our conflict within and outside us as we proceed through our daily life is a war. The guiding principles of honesty, obedience, valor, and sacrifice, as Abhimanyu displayed, should be our choice in the path of our salvation, the Dharma. Mm-hmm.